हेलो फ्रेंड्स, इन चैप्टर नंबर 12 इलेक्ट्रिसिटी, आफ्टर सॉल्व द टेक्स्ट बुक इलस्ट्रेशंस, वी गो थ्रू द टेक्सुअल एक्सरसाइज क्वेश्चन नंबर और एग्जांपल नंबर 14. द इंफॉर्मेशन सेज अस दैट कंपेयर द पावर यूज इन द 2 ohm resistor in each of the following circuits. In the information, we have two type of circuits. First is a 6 volt battery in series with 1 ohm and 2 ohm resistors, and second, a 4 volt battery in parallel with 12 ohm and 2 ohm resistors. In both cases, we compare the power with both circuits. Let's solve the example with the calculate with the power. First we find the power of in first case 6 volt battery, 2 resistors connected in series. So in case A, 2 resistors are connected in series. So equivalent resistance of this situation is Rs is equal to R1 plus R2. So here R1 is 1, R2 is 2. So we have the resistance 3 ohm. With the help of resistance, we can find the current. Here the resistance connected in series is, so we write Is is equal to V upon Rs. Here we have 6 volt battery, so 6 upon 3, 3 to the 6. Here we get Is is equal to 2 ampere. But we find the power, so we use the formula of power with the help of electric current and resistance. Here one thing is notice, you have to take the power 2 ohm, which is given in main information, not take 3 ohm, otherwise answer will be wrong. So one thing is important here. P1 is equal to Is square R. I square R here connected in series, so we take Is square R. Take the values of all. Is is equal to 2, so 2 square, R we take 2 ohm, not 3, square of 2 is 4, 2, 4 2 is 8. Here we get P1 in first case, the power is, here we write the symbol, 8 volt. Now go through in second case, 4 volt battery, 2 resistance in parallel, 2 resistance can be available, 12 ohm and 2 ohm. Now you go through with the theory and you can remember that in parallel combination, the voltage will be same. V1 is equal to V2 is equal to V3. So here we can't find the total equivalent resistance. We directly find the power in parallel combination, voltage will be same. So we can't have to find the equivalent resistance. In series, current will be same, voltage will be not same. So we find first the equivalent resistance Rs and we get the current. Here in parallel combination, we directly take the voltage in parallel combination. Voltage will be same in both resistance. Both resistors. So we use the formula of power which give two information about voltage and resistance. Here we take 2 ohm resistor when we find the power, because compare power with 2 ohm resistor. So in P2 we use the formula V square upon R. V square, here we have 4 square, R means 2, 4 to the 16, 4 square, 4 multiply 4, 16, upon 2, 8 to the 16. So here we get P2. So value of P2 is 8 volt. What is the values are says us that when we compare it, we take P1 upon P2. So P1 is, value of P1 is 8 watt, P2 is 8 watt, 8 cancel, what will be cancel, it is 1. So the answer says us that in both cases power will be same, P1 is equal to P2. Now we go through exercise number 15. Here we have two type of lamp. One lamp have the power 100 watt and the voltage will be 220 volt. Second lamp, the voltage watt will be, watt means power. Power is 60 watt. And the voltage are same in both, 220 volt. Both lamp are connected in parallel in the electric circuit. What will be the current drawn in the combination in the resistors? So we have to find, first we have to find resistance of both the cases in one lamp and in first lamp and in second lamp. So we find the equivalent resistance in both case, in first case, in first lamp. One lamp, or you called it first lamp. In first lamp power will be 100 watts, so we write P1 is equal to 100 and volt will be 220 watt. In use the formula V square upon R, but when we make the subject of R, first we write the formula P1 is equal to V square upon R. So when we make subject R is equal to V square upon P1 is equal to V square means 220 into 220 upon P1 is 100. 1010 cancel. 22 multiply with 22, we know it is 848 ohm. So in first case we have to R1 is equal to 484 ohm. Let's go through second case. In second lamp, we have two power, suppose P2, 60 watt, and voltage will be same, 220 volt. So use directly use R2 is equal to V square upon P2. V square means 220 into 220 upon 60. 10 will be cancelled. 22 multiply 22, again it is 484. 10 will be added and divided by 6, so we get it 806.7. Here we can write it 4840 divided by 6, 806.7. Now we have to the way we have values of both resistors R1 and R2, but R1 and R2 are connected in parallel combination. So when we find the total resistance, equivalent resistance of Rp is equal to 1 upon Rp is equal to 1 upon R1 plus 1 upon R2 is equal to 1 upon 484 plus 1 upon 806.7. Now we solve the calculation. 806.7 plus 484 upon 806.7 into 484. When we add 806.7 in, when we add 484, we get something like 1290.7. When we multiply 806.7 into 484, we like something like this, 390442.8. Multiplication is quite long. Another thing, all things are easy. Here we can get 1 upon Rp. So Rp is equal to, now we reciprocal it, inverted it, 442.8 upon 1290.7. When we calculate 390.442.8 divided by 1290.7, we get 302.8. Here we can have the value of Rp 302.26. Now you, when you divide it. Now we go through, now we find the current. What is the current? So we find the current easily. We have V is equal to 220 volt, and we already find Rp 302.6. So I is equal to V upon Rp. V is equal to 220 and Rp is 302.6. So 0.7272, it is nearest to here, not 0, which is mistake in digest. So 0.7272 something like this. So this will be nearest to 73. So current will be 0.73 ampere. First we find R1, then we find R2 in this stage, Still this stage it is the calculation is easy while you can multiply it, while you can divide it, you can have the values of multiplication and submission and you have to RP is equal to 302.6, so you can find electric current easily with the formula of I is equal to V upon RP. 220 upon 302.6 is equal to nearest to 0.73. Textual exercise number 14 and 15. Now we go through the exercise number 16. We have the TV set and toaster. TV set, the watt is 250 watt in work in 1 hour, and toaster watt power is 1200 1200 watt in 10 minutes. We have to compare which is the more consumed electric energy. Before comparison, first we find the electric energy in both instruments, in TV set and in toaster. So first we find in TV set, we use the formula, we find electric energy W is equal to P into T. So power means 250 and 1 hour, so it converted into 3600 second, so we get 9 1 2 3 4 5, but it is in the joule, so we convert first in kilojoule. We write it in same way, 10 raised to 5. When we convert into kilojoule, we multiply it with 10 raised to minus 3. So we have to 10 raised to 2, 900 kilojoule. In first case, in the case of TV set. Now we go through the second case. In the case of toaster, W is equal to P into T, power 1200. Here again minute, in minute we convert into second, so 10 into 60 second. So 1200 into 600. Now we calculate 12 multiply with 6. We get something 7 2 1 2 3 4. Again it is in the joule, so we write it into 10 raised to 4. 72 into 10 raised to 4 we convert it, multiply with minus 10 raised to minus 3 is equal to 720. Now in both cases result says us that here we have the digit 900 kilojoule and here 720 kilojoule, so we can say easily the 250 watt TV set consume more energy in compare of 1200 watt toaster in 10 minutes. 250 वॉट टीवी सेट इन 1 आवर कंज्यूम मोर एनर्जी कंपेयर ऑफ 1200 वॉट टोस्टर इन 10 मिनट. लेट्स गो विथ अनदर क्वेश्चन एग्जाम्पल 17. हियर द रेजिस्टेंस विल बी 8 ओहम एंड द करंट विल बी 15 ओहम विच इज पास थ्रू इन 2 आवर्स एंड वी फाइंड इट हीट इज डेवलप इन द हीटर amount of heat is developed in the heater instrument is heater. So when we find which type of how many heat is developed, so heat is developed means we find the power of heater. So when we find the power, we use formula P is equal to I square R. According to our information, we use the formula. Here we have the electric current and resistance, so we use I square R. We can't use V square upon R. We don't have the voltage in this case. I square means 50 square. R means 8, 50 multiply with 15, it is 225, it is 1800 watt, or you called it P is equal to 1800 joule per second. Now we multiply 225 with 8, we get 1800 joule per second. Let's go through the exercise, not example, it is exercise. 18, we give the scientific reason for some 5 sentences. First is, why the tungsten is a metal which is used in the filament which is made by bulb is made by filament. In filament, why tungsten is used? So the most effective reason is the melting point of tungsten. Tungsten is metal and melting point of tungsten is very high. It is 3380 degrees Celsius. So it is used in the filament. And the second thing is it is more flexible. So it is used in filament. Now the second, in some instruments like bread, toasters and electric irons are made of alloy instead of pure metal. We already know the pure metal have good conductivity. They are good conductors for electricity. So when use bread, toaster and electric iron which is made by pure metal, the chances of high electricity can be passed. so they are made up of alloy instead of pure metal. Series combination are, why series combination cannot use in the domestic circuits? We already know the drawbacks of series combination. In series combination, all instruments can be connected in series. So in domestic purpose, one instrument cannot work. All the instruments can stop its working. So in domestic purpose, all instruments can be connected in parallel combination. So one instrument cannot work, all instrument cannot stop its working. Resistance of wire vary with its area of cross section. We already know the resistance is proportional to 1/A. So when we think while the wire is thick, large cross section area, it will be the less resistance. And in second case, the wire will be thin, it will be more resistant. Why copper and aluminum wires can be used in transmission? So we already know the copper and aluminum are lower resistance, so they are good conductors for electricity. And the price will be less in comparison of other. Silver is also good conductor of electricity, but we cannot use the wire of silver because it is very costly. So we use the copper and aluminum wire for transmission. So here we complete the textual exercise question number 18, two examples 16 and 17.